Hello, everybody, and welcome to the first episode of the RGVFC FIFA 19 Career Mode Series. My name is Setsuno Choa, and I am the host of the RGVFC podcast Down in the Valley, and we usually go live every Wednesday at 7 p.m. So be sure to check that out if you're a fan of USL play, if you're a fan of, especially if you're a fan of RGVFC. So let's go ahead and get this started. We are going to be playing the Toros in the EFL League 2 league. Pardon the redundancy. So let's go ahead and set everything up. We'll set myself up as the manager. Obviously, my nationality is from the United States, so let's go ahead and take care of that. I want to be the young guy, because everybody else looks old. You got the messy looking guy, you got the Buffon looking guy. Well, I'll take the messy looking guy. Let's take a look at all of the other options for the career mode. Now let's go ahead and go with legendary for now. 8 minutes is fine. Dollars, HB Park, obviously. We'll disable the transfer window in the first league. And let's go ahead and get this ready. Usually I disable the transfer window because, you know, I wanna get a feel of what the current roster plays like in the game. I did make the team from scratch. Let me make a pause here because let's go ahead and accept a preseason tournament invite. We got the European International Cup, the Champions Trophy, and the European Continental Shield, but let's go ahead and go with the International Trophy. And let's go ahead and start. Seems legit. That guy did not have any arms. All right, so let's take a look at the roster for RGVFC Toros in FIFA 19. We have Michael Salazar. Obviously, we have Chuy Enriquez, my boy Chuy Enriquez, Malik Foster, Wilmer Cabrera Jr., Romilio Hernandez, Isidro Martinez, Robert Coronado, Kyle Adams, Eric McHugh, who should not be there. It actually should be. There we go. Connor Donovan and Andrew Samuels, as well as Nico Corti as the regular starting 11. And the bench, we have Camilo Monroy, Carlos Small, Andres Arcila, Nico Lemoine, Ben Willis, Robert Castellanos, Sam Junqua. And then in our reserves, we have Victor Garza and Brandon Morales, both of them from the Rio Grande Valley. You got Zach Jackson, David Cabrera, Michael Nelson, the third keeper for the Houston Dynamo. We have Hector Copete, who reflects, who I added using the cheat engine, the ability to reflect, you know, his current injury. He's out for, I think, for the rest of the season. So the game reflects that. You've got Carlos Viveros as well, Brad Dunwell, Kevin Rodriguez, Aldo Quintanilla, who is also showing his injury. He won't be back until August, according to the man himself. Thank you, Carson Merck, for that interview that you had with him about his rehabilitation. And you've got Eric McHugh, the Houston Dynamo homegrown that is sometimes loaned down to RGVFC. And welcome to the first game of the European International Cup between RGVFC Toros and FCBG from Norway. And we are now off here at Veltins Arena for this inaugural match of the European International Cup. The lineup for RGVFC is as follows: Nico Corti on goal, Andrew Samuels, Connor Donovan, Kyle Adams, Robert Coronado, Romilio Hernandez, Isidro Martinez. I'll leave that back because here comes Malik Foster. Malik Foster trying to go up against two defenders, passes the ball back to Chuy Enriquez, looks for Michael Salazar, he's going to take the shot, but the Norwegian team's defender is able to save the ball and the defense is able to clear it for a throw-in for RGVFC Toros. That was a close call. We're now in the 12th minute. Here comes Isidro Martinez back to Wilmer Cabrera Jr. But his shot goes a little bit too high off the mark. Let's take a look at the replay. He had the right idea, but he just could not position his body correctly to be able to actually have some sort of opportunity to put that ball in the back of the net. It's still 0-0 for the Toros, and we're now nearing the 14th minute of play. We are now in the 22nd minute, and we have a throw-in for the Norwegian team. BNG is going to take the cross, but Connor Donovan is able to clear that out for Michael Salazar. Returns the ball to Wilmer Cabrera Jr. Is there a counterattacking opportunity? Here it comes. Through ball over to Michael Salazar. One-on-one against the keeper. The defender's trying to nudge his way into it. Can't find a good pass. Michael Salazar takes the ball back to Wilmer Cabrera Jr. Has to go back outside the box. Back to Romilio. Back to Isidro Martinez. Looking for Wilmer outside the box. Inside the box for Michael Salazar. But Michael Salazar's shot goes just a little bit too wide off of the goal. But it looks like the Toros have been a lot more closer in trying to find that first goal of the match than their opponents in the, but their accuracy just has not been that great. If they have plans to win this match, they've got to capitalize on those chances. 28th minute and the Toros are still looking for that go-ahead goal. Michael Salazar returns to Robert Coronado. Isidro Martinez finds Romilio Hernandez looking for Malik Foster with the feint. Malik Foster inside the box. He's going to take the shot. No, he feints once again. He has to go back for Romilio Hernandez looking for Michael Salazar. Open it up for Chuy. Chuy, Chuy! Another save by the keeper. And it's still 0-0 in the 30th minute. Is there an opportunity for a counter? No, because Robert Coronado is able to stop that attack really, really, really well. 43rd minute now. We're approaching halftime and we got a throw-in for the Toros. Andrew Samuels just outside the box looking for Michael Salazar. Gets past his defender. But Michael Salazar, oh boy. He needed a lot more power than that in order to defeat the keeper. And now BNG have an opportunity right now. We got Sigurd Jonsson, but Andrew Samuels is able to intercept the ball well. His cross is picked off. Here comes BNG once again. Zinkernagel, but Kyle Adams, the eternal Kyle Adams, the New Zealander, is able to intercept the ball, and we got a counter opportunity here for the Toros. Here comes Wilmer Cabrera Jr. opening up for Malik Foster. Malik Foster tries to cross over to Michael Salazar. It is cleared away. It's still Toros ball. Michael Salazar has to go back from outside the box, tries to open it up for Chuy Enriquez, but the Norwegian team's defenders are able to clear the ball really well, and it's still 0-0. We're now in the 48th minute. And we're back for the second half. BNG have the ball. You have Bonifaci going back to Saltnes, to Zinkernagel. Bonifaci inside the box. Kyle Adams is able to take the ball away, but the referee calls a penalty. Penalty against RGBFC Toros. Penalty against Kyle Adams. I don't know what in the world the referee was thinking. Thankfully, Kyle Adams was not given a yellow for that. That was a soft PK call. You guys saw the replay. There was minimal contact on there. And it looks like it's going to be Bonifaz that's going to take the penalty against Nico Cordy. He takes a shot. Goal! BNG take the lead off of this penalty. Bonifaz completely fools Nico Corti, who throws himself the other way around. And the Toros are now going to have to climb up from behind if they want to salvage anything in this match. Victor Bonifaci with the lone goal in the 49th minute. It's the 52nd minute here, and here come the Toros trying to find that equalizer after that unfortunate penalty call. Here comes Wilmer Cabrera Jr., and he's going to make a chip through ball over to Malik Foster. Right on the volley, and it hits the crossbar. How unlucky for the Jamaican. Let's take a look at that replay. It was a beautiful contact with the ball, but it just hits the crossbar, and it goes over the goal. It's still 1-0 in the 53rd minute. The Norwegian team still has the advantage in this match. Can the Toros find the equalizing goal? We shall, hopefully that'll come soon. We're now in the 67th minute and the Toros are still pushing. They're still pushing to try to look for the equalizer. Michael Salazar is out in the wing looking for Wilmer Cabrera Jr. to Malik Foster. threw ball over to Wilmer Cabrera Jr. He's able to out-jostle his defender, but while he was looking for Camilo Monroy, who was one-on-one with the keeper, the pass was just too soft to be able to reach his destination. It's still 0-0 in the 69th minute. We are now reaching the 83rd minute, and the Toros are still down 1-0, but they keep on pushing. Here comes Wilmer Cabrera Jr. He's going to open it up for Michael Salazar. Is he going to get the crossover to Caliche? Madre mía, Caliche de la que te acabas de perder. How did he sky that? That's incredible. That was a perfect opportunity for the Toros to get level. And he completely forgave his opponent. Son goles que no vuelven, madre santísima. We're in the 84th minute and the Toros are still down 1-0 and time is running out. They really need to take advantage of these opportunities. Oh, it's crunch time now. We're nearing stoppage time. And here comes Camilo Monroy. The Toros are still attacking. Andres Arcila looking for Michael Salazar. He has to come out outside the box. Back to Arcila. Here comes Chelin. Isidro! Who goal? Cantala conmigo! Who goal? The Toros have found the equalizer in the death of the match. Isidro Martinez, the native of Brownsville, Texas, comes out the hero in this match. There's very little time. We've only got 2 minutes left. The Toros have to shut this match down if they want to get away with the point that they've managed to salvage against BNG. Here comes, but BNG are not going to let that happen. But good interception, but they get the ball back. Here comes BNG. Robert Coronado, good job defending in the back. The defense hasn't really looked bad. It's been the attack that's kind of been a little bit lackluster with their lack of accuracy in their shots. And here's the final whistle. Your RGVFC Toros were able to salvage a point in their debut of the European International Cup, tying in the 90th minute by Isidro Martinez. 1-1 RGVFC Toros against BNG of Norway. Not the best result if we want to make it far, but it's better than not getting no points at all in this tournament. But there's enough time to fix the mistakes, and hopefully we can get a better result in the next match of this tournament. So before we call off this episode, let's take a look at my inbox. We've got the Toros Bird. We got Hector Copete. You're injured. Get out of here. You're injured. You can't play. You got the Toros board with a couple of emails. You got the assistant manager. It's not really important. If you guys enjoyed this video, be sure to give it a like. Be sure to share it. Be sure to give it a thumbs up. Talk about it. Leave a comment. What do you guys like? Leave your thoughts about the real world RGBFC as well. Don't forget that every Wednesday at 7 p.m. on this channel, Jacob and I, we go live to talk about the RGBFC Toros in our internet show and podcast called Down in the Valley. It's usually about 2 hours long, but if you guys are interested in talking about, you know, USL or especially RGV, be sure to check us out. Be sure to subscribe to the channel and be sure to also click on that bell to make sure you receive notifications every time that we go live. Also, on Tuesday at 7 p.m. on this same channel, we have what we call Generation Orange. But this is more focused on the Houston Dynamo. Sean and I, we talk about the Houston Dynamo and, of course, Houston Dash, RGBFC as well, and U.S. soccer in general. But that's it for this episode. Hope you all enjoy it. We'll see y'all in the next one. Take care.